Is this a procedure or Raspberry? Yes, it is. Is it done with geometry nodes? Of course it is. And is it hard to make? No, so let's make one.
When we need to create a Raspberry, we need a base mesh. And this is our base mesh. So now we go to this new geometry nodes workspace, and let's add a new set of geometry nodes. So when we look at the Raspberry, we see it has some balls, right? I don't know how these balls are called in English, but let's say these are like the juicy balls, right? So for that, we can use a point instance node or a point distribute node. Point instance creates points on every vertex of the mesh. So let's add a small cube here. This is gonna be the tiny ball of the Raspberry. And now for the original Raspberry, we're gonna instance this tiny ball, right? And now on every vertex we have this tiny ball, and we want to make it also smaller. So let's add an attribute fill node, which is gonna allow us to fill the scale attribute with a certain number. So let's use the scale attribute and let's fill it with the value of 1. They have exactly the same size as this sphere has here. Let's make them smaller, and you see on every vertex we have a point. This is not very Raspberry like so let's use another node called point distribute. You see random written here, and this means that the points are going to be distributed randomly, just as you see here. We can increase the density and we have more, but it's still not looking like a Raspberry. What a Raspberry has is a hole on the top. So to create this hole here, what you have to think of is that, let's say it's a Raspberry, and we're gonna make this a little bit bigger. We wanna make sure that the hole is appearing around here, and on the z-axis, this part here is 0, right? And this part here is 1, and this here is 2. So to create the hole here, we just have to get rid of all of these balls, right? And we have to make sure that the density of the point distribute is 0 there and 1 down here. And we can do that using a compare node. So we can use the attribute compare, and with this node we can compare the Z position of this Raspberry. So let's type in here Z position of this Raspberry, and we can compare it to a float, which is a single value. In our case, this should be 1, right? And this results in an attribute called density. When we input this density here, everything disappears. And that's because you see there's a little exclamation sign here, and this says that no attribute with name zPosition. So we have to create an attribute called zPosition. And to create this zPosition attribute, we can take the position attribute and divide it into 3 different parts, x, y, and z. And for that, again, another new node called attribute separate x, y, z. Let's type in here position, since this is the attribute we wanna divide into 3 parts or separate into 3 parts. The result x is gonna be x, the y is gonna be y, and the z is gonna be r. No, it's gonna be z, of course. Now we have these attributes x, y, and z. We could actually call this also z position, since this is what we're gonna use here. And as you see, we have this effect, but it's inverted. And that's because everything that's greater than 1 is gonna be having the value of 1. So everything that's greater up here is having the value of 1 for the density, so all the balls are gonna appear there. And if you wanna have it inverted, we can just switch it to less than. So everything that's lesser or smaller in value than this 1 is gonna have the density of 1. The balls are gonna appear there. This is already more like a Raspberry. I wouldn't eat this, definitely. It looks like too scary. What we have to do now is to change the scale of these points to be random. So if you want to do something random, for that we have a node called attribute randomize, right? So let's write here scale. I know the scale is randomized from 0 to 1. We don't want that. Let's just play around with those, you know. And you see they are overlapping in a very strange sense. To fix that, we can use the Poisson disk of this point distribute. And this algorithm just gives you the minimum distance between 2 points. So when we increase this, it's looking more like a berry. Crank up this density and let's make it not so random in size. 0.28 is looking pretty nice. Now what we have to do is to deal with this aging animation or ripening animation. To create this ripening animation, we have to make this berry bigger. We can displace every point by the normal. The normal is telling us in which direction is this ball, for example, looking at. It's looking around there, and this ball down here is looking down, and this one here is looking at this direction, and so on. So if you move every ball outwards by this direction, well, we should have a bigger berry, right? So to do that, we can use an attribute mix node, attribute mix, and let's add to the position of these points the normal of these points. And this is going to result back in the position, right? Because we eventually want the position of all these points to change. Now we have this factor slider, and when it's zero, it's the same thing as before. But when you move this up, they're gradually getting bigger. The young raspberry does look okay, but the old one does look very strange because it has holes in it. We can fix that by going to this poison disk distribution here and changing the minimum distance, and also making these balls a bit bigger. Maybe change the seed if something looks a bit too strange. And now this is our raspberry, right? But here's the problem. The small raspberry is like a ball, but the big raspberry is also like a ball, and this isn't correct at all. The bigger one should be something like that. Let's add another attribute mix node, and let's think what we can do to solve this retarded looking raspberry, right?
So we can take the position of these points and multiply their z location with a larger number so that they become stretched out on the z axis. And if we want to do something on a single axis, we can use a vector.
X, Y, and Z, we have to change them on the z axis, and the result will be a change in position, right? Now it looks like that, and when I mix those, it does something strange.
The first thing we have to fix is to make sure it doesn't mix between this position and this vector, but it multiplies the position with this vector, and this creates something better, but still it does look pretty retarded. So type 111 here, because when it's zero, then it's just gonna eventually become a worm or line, whatever. So let's type in here 1, and let's make this one here a bit bigger, turn this factor up. Let's make sure that our final raspberry is gonna look something like that. So that's a small raspberry, and this is the big one. And now let's use a value node as the factor of both of these. So we can control it, it's small, and now it's big. Small, big, middle-sized. We do have some problems with the points, so we have to adjust something here with this distance between them, and maybe make them just a tiny bit bigger. The raspberry is looking pretty nice. And you think this tutorial is gonna end here? No, it isn't. We have a problem. And the problem is that when you make it smaller, put the 3D cursor here and make it bigger, you see it has moved up. And if you have some leaves and some stalk of this berry, then it's gonna intersect and it's not gonna look very nice. To fix that, we're gonna use another attribute mix node. Let's drive the position again with a vector and result back in position. But which kind of a vector? Well, when it's small, it is here. And when it's big, it should be here. So it has to be moved down on the z-axis. So on the z-axis, we can subtract something from the position of this raspberry. So let's use the subtract here, put the factor to 1, and let's subtract something like that here. So when I move this factor to 0, it's up there, and when I move it here, it's in the correct position. And let's use the same value here, and now when I make it smaller or bigger, it stays in the same place, in the range of 0 to 1. If this raspberry is already picked, it's empty from the inside. But when this raspberry isn't picked, it has an interior. And we're gonna create this, of course, procedurally. We add a cylinder, because now you can add meshes in the geometry node workspace. And let's also add a join geometry node to output both of these cylinder and also the raspberry to the geometry output. First, of course, the cylinder is very sharp, so let's add a subdivision surface modifier and put it here and increase the level a bit. And let's not use the N-gon but the triangles, so it looks like that. And this is a pretty good interior already. We have to make it bigger, and for that we have a transform node. Transform node, and I'm gonna put it in a better space here, like that. So the transform node has the translation, rotation, and scale. First, let's make it bigger. Let's use a combine XYZ node, and let's input 1 everywhere. So now it's the same scale as it was before. I use the combine XYZ because I want to have more control over the X, Y, and Z, when here I can just only have one input and it changes all of these values at once. So I take this vector, plug it here, and let's make it bigger on the X and Y, something like that. And on the Z, it should be something like that. Add another combine XYZ, plug it into the translation, and let's move it down on the Z axis. But now when we make this smaller, and actually I should have a quick control for that. So let's plug one from here, and also from here. And now we have a single control for all of these parameters, and we can call this age. When the age is at 1, it looks pretty nice. When it's 0, it doesn't look very nice. So we have to use the same age value and drive
the translation and scale of this interior, basically. When the age is at 1, it looks very strange now, and when it's at 0, it looks even more strange, it has disappeared. So we can fix that by using a map range node. Let's take the map range node and let's drive the scale by this 1 node for a moment, or actually just the x and y scale. So the map range takes the original scale, which goes from 0 to 1, and you see from minimum 0 from maximum 1. This is the original scale and it remaps it to a different scale. Right now it's at the maximum position, so we can increase the maximum. As you see, it isn't wide enough. So let's increase the maximum to something like that. And now let's turn it down and it has disappeared. So let's increase the minimum to something like that. So the X and Y scale of this interior part is looking pretty nice. The Z isn't very nice. So let's make this map range smaller. Let's add a new one here. Let's connect the Z scale. We can't make any decisions right now because it's offset so much. So let's use another map range. And this map range is gonna drive the Z position. Turn it down to 1 and it's at the minimum position, so we have to change the minimum to here. And when you move it to the maximum, let's also turn this maximum down to around here. And now what we can do is to go back to the scale thing here and adjust the Z scale to make sure it's perfect. And now that we have mapped everything, you can see that the age and the interior part are in a pretty good correlation. It looks like a Raspberry. And now we have the one final detail, and this is adding this little hair on the surface of this Raspberry. I have 3 wonderful hair, and we're gonna put them on the surface of this Raspberry. To make these little things appear on the surface of this Raspberry, we could use the same point distribute node, or the points created by this point distribute node, and just instance on the same locations, but you see like they're appearing on the exact same locations, and this does look pretty weird. So what we have to do is to duplicate this whole thing like that and drag the geometry from here. Now we have 2 identical copies of the shape of the Raspberry. The first one is going to be used for the Raspberry and the other points are going to be used for the little hair. So let's use another point instance node and let's drag the second copy here. Let's use a collection, uncheck the whole collection, and let's use the, I call them tails in Estonian. Drag them to this join geometry and we can't see them. Well, that's because they are too small. So let's use an attribute fill node to fill the scale attribute with a different number than the small number they have right now. They are still on the same locations, and that's because, well, it's an identical copy, you know. What we can do is to change the seed, and they're looking different now. Well, also there isn't so many here on a Raspberry, this would be kind of gross. So we can increase the distance and also bring down the density quite a bit. And what we can also do is to change the scale and maybe even randomize the scale. This is looking more like a real Raspberry. The Raspberry is ready. We have a lot of nodes here and we have the single age. Oh, you see, I forgot to use the quick controls on the nodes down here as well. And here, and now when I make it smaller, it works, you know. So the Raspberry is ready now. You're gonna ask me, how can I change the color of the Raspberry when it's getting older? Well, for that we have drivers. So you go to the shading workspace, you add a material for this little ball here, which is the basis of this Raspberry. And for the base color, you add a mix RGB node. When the factor is 1, it's gonna have the color when it's like ripened. So something like really, really red. And when the factor is 0, it's gonna have the color of something very fresh and not very sweet to eat. And now we have to change between this and that when it's getting older or when it's still young. Now to make the slider move with the age, we're gonna use a driver. Right click here and add a driver. Go here and select single property. So a single property in Blender is gonna drive the value of this mix RGB node. The object is gonna be our Raspberry. And the path is the data path of this value. So to get this value, we're gonna select the Raspberry again, take this age thing here and copy data path. And back in this material, we go and edit this driver and paste the path here. And now when it changes the age, it's getting greener or more red. And I'll just add some subsurface scattering, connect the color to the subsurface color like that, and then transmission, and this is like a Raspberry. I'm not gonna show you the whole material because this is not the point of this tutorial. If you wanna see what I use, the material is here. I'm also not gonna show you how to make these leaves because, you know, the leaves are really simple. I believe in you, you can make these. They are just planes with a green texture, you know. So well done, now you have your own Raspberry. They are useful. You can make tea or jam or animate them, well, you choose. If you have a thing to ask, let me know. Either me or someone from the subscriber mafia will help you. And that's pretty much it. I am gonna go.